Today, we are going to learn how to create a sales CRM in Notion. If you've ever done sales before, then you already know how important it is to be able to have a solid system for you to be able to track all of your leads, all of your projects, and all of your tasks. Now, one of the parts of sales that can get really confusing if you don't have a system is the entire outreach process. What companies or individuals have you contacted? What is the status? What are the important details? How do they prefer to be contacted, etc.? Now, from my experience of being a freelancer and an agency founder, one of the easiest ways to be able to track all these details is by just creating a quick setup in Notion. So let's go ahead and talk about how to do that. Now, real quick, if you don't want to go through the process of building this entire thing, I do have one that's already created for you that you can use, which is the one that you see here. If you want to download it, just click the first link in the description. All right, so for everyone else, let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing that I want to do is create a text heading, and then I want to create a database for my contacts. After that, let's go ahead and remove the database title, open one of the pages, and now we're going to add some helpful properties. Now let's go ahead and add our first contact, and let's say it's me. So whenever you have a new contact that you want to add to your database, all that you need to do is go over and click this new icon and you can fill out their information. So let's close this page. And to be honest, I don't really want to have all this information laid out on this one page. If I want to get any additional details about a contact, I can just open it and find it there. So in order to clean up the view, I'm going to go ahead and just hide a few of these. So now that we have that, what we need to create is your sales pipeline. This is what you're going to use to track all of the outreach that you have with your potential clients. All right, cool. So as we do with all databases, let's go ahead and hide that title. And then one of the first things that I'm going to do is go over to the grouping of this board, change the status by to option. I just think that this is a little bit of a cleaner look personally. Before we move on, I am going to rename a couple of these status columns, and then I'm also going to add a couple of new ones. So we can do that by clicking the three dots, going over to properties and selecting status. Now we've updated these to be a bit more reflective of what you might find on a regular sales CRM, and I added these two columns. So obviously the most ideal situation is you start someone as a lead, then you move them to in conversation, and then you eventually win the account. Now, if you reached out to somebody and you did not close the account, you can always go ahead and drag their card under the close loss column. And after that, what I recommend doing is just opening the page and then going ahead and adding some notes to it so that you know exactly why that happened so that you can prevent it from happening again in the future. And then this other column that we created is simply so that this closed one column doesn't get overloaded with a bunch of different clients. Obviously, that's a great scenario to be in, but just to make sure that your workspace doesn't get too crowded, what you can do is you can click these three dots, you can click hide. We're going to do that with the closed lost as well. That way, they don't really take up that much room in your canvas, and you can very easily see everything that's going on that needs your attention right now. All right, so let's go ahead and keep on setting this up. Go ahead and open one of the pages, and now we want to start adding some properties to the sales pipeline pages. And the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and delete the assign property. And after that, I want to add a relation. Now, this relation is going to be connected to our CRM contacts database right below. So now what I can do is click this box and go ahead and select the clients that are connected to this project that I'm currently trying to secure. Now, after that, we're going to go ahead and add a rollup property. Now, since we set up the relation, which connects those two databases, this makes it so that I can pull specific information from that other database. So I'll hit select, click the contacts database, and then from there, I want to go ahead down to company and just put show original. And now we're good to go on that. What I want to do now is go ahead and name this item in the sales pipeline. Now, like I mentioned before, I run an agency. So what I typically do whenever I'm reaching out to people is I make the project that I want to hit them up about the title. So let's say that I was reaching out to myself at Notionland and I wanted to do a website design. What I want to do next is edit this so that I can see a little bit more information in this card preview. We click these three dots, open up the properties, and I'm going to make the contacts as well as the company information visible. This is great because at a glance, I see the information that I need. And if I'm reaching out to 50 or 100 people about different projects, I need to be able to see this information rather than going, okay, website design, let me either click into the page or go down to the contacts and try and figure out which one is associated with this. Okay, so let's say that you have secured this account for website design. What happens next? The next step for us is to create a projects database. All right, so we have that ready. And just like before, go over to these three dots, go ahead and click the group, status, buy, and then switch that to option. Now let's open the page and we will start adding some properties. Now, quick note, one thing that I want to do before I set this relation property to be active is I'm going to go ahead and make it so that it shows on the CRM contacts database as well. And then when I view the contacts page, I'll be able to see all the projects that they're attached to. All right, so the four properties that we set up are the contacts relation, the timeline for the project, as well as the value of the project. So I'm gonna go ahead and just fill in some information right here. What I recommend doing for the timeline is, let's say this started January 1st, go down here and select the end date to be enabled. And then last but not least, let's go ahead and pick the contact that is associated with the project. Now, one final detail that I'm gonna add here is the roll-up option that we talked about earlier. So in the same way that we set this up for the sales pipeline so that the company name automatically appears, we want to do that for the project as well. And we'll go ahead and add the name of this. Now, just like we did with the board below, I want to go ahead and show a bit more information on this card preview. So the two things that I'm going to show right here are the company as well as the timeline, just so I know when that due date is coming up. If you want to add more to this, what you can do is always open up the project page and either hit slash check and you can pull up a to-do list that you can use for the different tasks for the project. Or what you can do is create a database within the project that's specifically for tasks. Now, this is just a quick example of how you could do it. If you want a template that has all this already built for you, like I said before, click the link in the description and you can get the full template. And that just about wraps things up. So now you have a CRM that has a contacts database, a full sales pipeline, so you can track the progress of your conversations. And once you've won those accounts, you can track all the progress of their projects in this board right up here. Now, if there are any specific tutorials that you want to see from me in the future on how to use Notion for different stuff, just leave a comment. I will see it and I will add it to my list. Thank you again for checking out the video, and until next time, I'll see you next time.